Ya, assalamualaikum and very good evening. We are group 38 for Lex 2003 movie review. We are recording for discussion for week 2. Week 3, but this is a discussion,
the second
video. Okay, my name is Muhairin, metric number 177112.
Hi, my name is Siti Nur Atika Binti Azhari and my metric number is 178032.
Hi, my name is Nurhani Siti Aspar. My metric number is
180110.
Hello,
my name is
Muhammad Khalid Azhar. My metric number is
180101. Hello, my name is Nur Shafira Binti Idris. My metric number is 195256.
Hello, my name is Nida Shafika Binti Muhammad Zabidi. My metric number is 188687.
My name is Tang Kui Ling, matrix number 189040.
Hello, my name is Chui Munyi. My metric number is 188181.
I'm Norena Aisha Binti Sakiman. Matrix number is 191239.
Hello, my name is Tajiman Karis Vanessa. My metric number is 188048.
Okay, previously we already agreed to choose a Maleficent movie. Have all of you watched the movie?
Yes.
I just watched it just now.
You can just watch it yesterday.
I watched it yesterday.
Yeah, same.
For the sake of this, I didn't skip anything.
Yeah.
Good for you.
It's a good movie.
Okay, in general,
okay.
Do you enjoy the movie?
Obviously. I love this movie.
Why is that?
Why?
There's one dragon and it's better than the princess. I have mentioned. I have to
compare. Do not compare.
So I know. You see, for the sake of these facts, is there anything you want to say about this movie? Because I want to.
I hate to say that I like this movie a lot.
I think the climax is nicely done. Plot twist is the biggest plot twist ever for Disney movie. I really love, especially because my bias in, you know, in American celebrity is Angelina Jolie.
Girl crush.
Despite that fact, I really love how they use they combine between CGI and attention, right?
Yes.
So it didn't seem like it was fake. I mean, meaning it was there. I didn't see it was there because it looks like theatrical. It just looks theatrical. Yeah, CGI. What else do you think the performance
have something to say?
Oh, I agree to your plot twist because I also love that plot twist.
Yeah,
why? I thought that the Maleficent would be the bad villain until the end of the story. But then I didn't expect that she would give the keys to the Princess Aurora. I thought that the keys from the Prince Charming would have the effect on her, but then she didn't wake up. So, okay.
like Elsa.
You know, like the kids from the sisters.
Yeah.
They had a hard time going through the tall and stuff. And then for the comic part, the three fairies.
It looks like the three idiots.
In the previous one I watched, the fairy tale one, the three fairies are very capable of doing all the housework. But this one, it's about like doing nothing at all. Just ruined the whole day.
They give carrots. That baby.
It's edible. It's edible.
And they just left it. And then she's like, why are you always hiding? Which the baby did can't walk. Couldn't even walk.
Yeah. But luckily the Maleficent show up a bit and then took over the baby sitting part.
Yeah. It's like actually like the baby.
Actually it is because of the three fairies that
The
curse. happening because of that the three fairies.
Because they come to the castle.
They accidentally spoke about her father, Aurora's father, to her. And then before her 16th birthday, she went to the castle and whatnot. And she got cursed. And after the three fairies, I think the name is
something like that.
One of the fairies, she spoke about, you have to stay here until the 16th and after a day of after your birthday, so that you can meet your father. And then she's like, you told me your parents were dead. And what happened? And that voice lured her to this room where all the spinning wheel, but one of the spinning, the broken one, it was fixed. And then she accidentally just touched
it.
She pricks her own finger and.
How about you?
Oh, okay. Can you
go first?
Oh,
yeah, go first.
Yeah, it's about, I think it's differently from you because that you said that it was because of the three fairies that she got cursed. I don't think.
No, no. So. I think because of those three fairies, they work the curse out. Meaning, it's bound to happen. It's bound to happen.
But I think that because this, she's already cursed, no matter
how she will be
in
the castle. How is that story gonna end if that's not because of the three fairies?
Yeah, so you are half right. But you said that they caused the curse. So,
yeah. But I think they may cause the curse because like they come to the Aurora when. Like she's in the
christening.
When they purpose the before that they go to the castle and they wish to give a gift to the baby. Yeah. I think if they don't go there, then Maleficent wouldn't go there to give a curse. Maybe.
I think Maleficent was angry at King Stephen.
Wouldn't
he?
I told you, right?
It's because of the three fairies. The story ends. It's how the climax goes. To show that she's going to get pricked with that spinning wheel thing, and then she's left to sleep forever for eternity.
But actually, Maleficent did give Aurora a good blessing, right?
Yeah. Good grace and.
Good grace.
Yeah.
Good grace and.
Beloved by people.
By everyone who is met by her, right? So that is why. Actually, Maleficent, her own self, is actually affected by her own blessing. That's why in the end, she also feed the baby, care for her, save her from the cave. And even in the end, she want to revoke
the curse.
I revoke the curse.
But she doesn't work, right? Yes. Because it's forever.
All power on earth cannot.
Cannot. The curse ate me.
For my own opinion, that I a bit dislike about the movie. It's a bit boring for me.
It's quite draggy.
For me, the movie is too much focused on women's power. That's why I don't like it.
See where you stand.
Are you a feminist?
I can
be a non-feminist.
It shows that it should be that men have the power to control the world. Men is the leader. However, from this movie, it shows that women have the most power.
Are you trying to discriminate women?
But this movie only focuses on the message.
Yes, the message. But I just don't like the movie flow. Other than that, when the Maleficent want to war with the army. Okay, it's just that only one woman can control the world, to control the nature, to fight against the army, which is all the men.
She is said to be the strongest.
That's why I think a man cannot never fight with women. However, they need to be
on par.
Something like that, lah. You know what I'm saying? It's like we cannot discriminate women because she will take revenge or do something more better. However, we cannot.
But just now you said you want men to be in control instead of women.
I think that is so wrong.
Yes, that's so selfish of you.
Okay, never mind.
You have a lot of opinions here. You have to be careful.
Yeah,
I'm one of those.
this Maleficent is nice.
Yeah, it's nice.
After that, the King Stephen.
He was a hero.
Philip.
No, the king that betrayed her, right? The king
Stephen.
That's why she burned.
Yes. He's the one that caused all this trouble.
You see what the guy did?
He took advantage of
the guy.
But he has some kind of mercy in him. Because instead of slaying her head off, he took the wings.
Only the wings.
The draggy wings. Yeah. So big.
But because of that, I think that he had some mental issue.
Yeah.
He kept on thinking and thinking, and then
he kept talking to that wings.
I find it quite weird, but he built up some defense around the castle, even at in the entrance. The tall spirit or what?
Iron burning spirits.
So maybe it's just like, the love turned to ice.
Yeah, because at first they were in love.
Yes.
But greedy took over him. He wanted to take the castle in the first place. He told Maleficent about it. But Maleficent didn't know. But
he should forget about it. She forgot about it.
No, she couldn't.
She was to learn.
Yeah. She was to learn. He said the narrator. She was to learn about the man's greedy. Man's greedy.
I think you're
good. How about you?
Are you going to agree with
say something?
Okay, what I can see is since the beginning of our discussion until now, you all agree about the Maleficent character, the King Stephen. So we can say that they played their role successfully, didn't they? Okay, what else? I just remember the part where the prince kissed Aurora, but no effect.
She didn't
awake. Yeah. Yeah. And Maleficent feels sad, didn't it?
Yeah. But because she thought the curse is not going to be revoked.
But then Maleficent kissed the Aurora.
Kissed Aurora.
And then we don't think it very, we just think it's straight. It is a motherly love.
And then
we're
just taking care of
the part where they both say, no truer love. And then I just want to continue, that part. No truer love than the love of a fairy godmother.
Not the love she made.
But I think it's the love between someone who has raised, you know, it's like a mother-like situation.
She took care of her.
She was the one who took care of her.
And the
she almost fell down the cliff, right?
But then
Maleficent helped her. Diva was like,
Everyone here liked the movie.
The only guy.
I didn't like it too.
Okay,
May I know why you don't like
the movie? Actually, the first time I watched the movie, I fell asleep actually.
I have a feeling that it's quite draggy. The first part, the intro part, was like, typical Disney, like, hi, hello, Mr. She was flying like that. It's typical. You can see a lot in Barbie, princess, Disney princess.
You stay with me, right? You skip the video, right?
No, but I watch it for the second time. I watch it for the sake of this.
Sherry Monyo, you skip.
Maybe we can ask Chiu. Also, there's a lot of
it. I think the front part and the middle part is a bit draggy.
Yeah.
It's too draggy. So, but the behind part is so interesting.
Yeah, the plot twist.
And then we cannot deny the fact that the visual effect and then the makeup, settings, the setup, all are very
nicely done.
Gorgeous. So, I think that is the point where we can take a lot of marks.
Very love the crown.
I love the part when did you turn me into dogs?
But actually, have you all seen the trailer for this movie?
No.
It's actually very scary.
I think I watched it. It's the part when
singing the song, the Sleeping Beauty song in a very like scary way, and I thought it was a horror movie.
So
I didn't dare watch at first, but then later I realized, oh, it's not horror.
It's not horror. It's not horror at all.
And unlike other Disney movies, it had no singing.
I think one thing I don't really like about Aurora is her voice.
Yeah.
It was too
like
a bit hoarse.
Groggy.
Really like boyish.
It's a girl,
she's a princess.
But her smile is so cute.
Yeah, but,
I thought the expression is quite.
She should not talk then.
You know, show her emotion very well.
So, I think got a lot of conflict between Stefan and the Vixian in the first place because. Maybe they are lacking of communication and then the misunderstanding come out of nowhere. What if they were to collaborate and then to communicate, would the same result happen? Like it's like King Stefan died at the end of the story, right?
Yeah. I don't think so. Maybe Aurora will be the daughter of King Stefan and
I think this is because both are not a good, very good kingdom. They don't have a good relationship. The Moors and the men. That's why the king always try hard to conquer that place, magical place. Magical creatures. I think that is why one thing Maleficent do not understand about men, about the greediness. She understood that once her wing was taken from her when she was out to sleep by Stefan. I don't know their English. Sounds like British, but not
British. What did they like meet?
It sounds British because. I'm not too sure. She said something like that.
But I don't think it's fully British.
I don't think so. Sometimes Stefan, he talked like not British, but not really American.
What do you think of the languages? Is it appropriate for old age home? Is it appropriate? I think it's appropriate because it's easy to understand. It doesn't use a bombastic word, but I think
it's just fine.
Should I recommend
this movie to children?
I think if you want to recommend this to people, you do not show them the trailer.
Yeah, don't show them the trailer.
Because there's this part where the girl's like, come on, you would be afraid. I'm not afraid. Something like that. And then she comes out with this like, people would be scared. I really say like kids would be scared of her. At first, because in the intro part, she didn't look as much as the trailer is.
Yeah.
She didn't look scary as the trailer shows. So I think the producer should take some fixing in the introducing trailer. What do you think, Nida? You've been quiet all this time.
What do you mean?
What do you mean?
I have been talking a lot in the beginning.
Well,
about the rating?
The rating.
Okay, you want to start first?
I'll start.
For me, 5 over 10 because I'm not satisfied with the unreal thing.
Oh,
not,
unrealistic.
I can bear the CGI effect, visual effect, but I don't understand why magician cannot feel during King Stephen
cut her wings.
I think she was drugged.
She was drugged.
Yeah, she was drugged.
Yeah.
Did
you watch that part?
He said
that
he
was
skipping.
No,
because he thought it's gonna be like a kissing scene.
No,
and then
maybe,
skip,
maybe
skip,
maybe
skip.
And then she fell asleep and then she was like, oh, they did that time.
And then
he
was like, oh, why was it? Is she
realize that her wings were cut off?
You just didn't watch the whole part.
No, I think maybe he watched, but he didn't see that
really?
Small,
that
part, but they just switched to that the bottle of poison
before switching back.
The poisoning bottle.
Yeah,
yeah,
it's the poisoning bottle.
And
okay,
it's really a shock.
I just want to ask you, if you have to choose between this version with the real original version, the fairy tale version, which one you will choose?
I guess,
you didn't see, right? The original one, right? The original one? Which
just
one?
Sleeping Beauty.
Oh, that was Sleeping Beauty.
Boys,
you
are
boys.
Let's see
how you're
going
to read bedtime story to your daughter.
Boring.
Oh my goodness. Okay. This is sad for your daughter.
Okay.
For me, 5 over 10. For me, it's a bit sleepy at first, but I watched
it. You were drugged.
Yes, I was drugged. No, after that I watched it with my friend, and yes, it's fine, but yeah, at the end, so I give.
I would
get
8 out of 10.
Okay, and as for me, I divide by 2 for the animation, graphics, CGI, and FS song. So I give it 8 over 10. However, for the movie, 4 over 10. So average is maybe 5 over 10.
As for me, I give 8 over 10. Even though it's a little bit draggy, but actually the movie is good because it have actually a good lesson learned. Like, we cannot judge people by its cover, and you might think people bad, but actually if you know that person really well, you will know that the real person attitude. You need to know them first. You cannot judge just by her look. Like, Maleficent look fierce, but if you know her really well, she actually a good person. So
yeah, I have to give this movie 9 out of 10. Hands down the best movie.
Hands down, really hands down.
I'll give 7 out of 10 for its good graphic, good acting, good makeup, good movie. Although it's a bit draggy, but I still like Disney movies.
Okay, for me, I love the sci-fi genre, and then it is visually beautiful, but the dark retelling of the classic fairy tale. Love the plot twist, like I expect the Prince Charming do the writing, but then turn out Maleficent do the job. So I will give a 8 over 10 rating because it surprised me at the end of the story. Yeah.
For me, I have to give it like 6 out of 10. I'm so sorry because it is not the most favorite, I could say, because the draggy thing really, really pulls out a point for me. I think that aside from Tang and Munyi's part, I agree with them a lot, so that's why I give them 6 out of 10. I give this movie.
I would give it a 7 out of 10 because I quite like the animation and the story plot, but yeah, it can be quite draggy.
Because I'm more of the fairy tale Disney princess kind, and not the like this kind of like
villain hero.
Yeah, villain hero
plot twist.
Kind of, so yeah, of 7.
Okay.
So in the end, drum roll, please, for our group. We have higher than average, 6.8.
All right,
not bad.
Okay, we can conclude our discussion on magician where the girls only like this movie.
I have to agree.
Okay, that's all from us. Thank you.
See you next time.
Bye.